Hello guys, this is Leo the Wise, giving to all men, their needed uprise.
Hello men, dear boys, this is the second and last part of my video, content of an article from MGTOW.com titled, Don't Argue with Women. Truth, as well as morals, are only important to women when it suits them. The instant the truth conflicts with their agenda, they have no problems at all changing it and carrying on, because what they are really after is manipulating you. The most manipulative is the winner. The one who manipulates the most crapola upon the other is the one who walks away being right. Truth matters not a bit in deciding who is right. You can catch a woman dead to rights in a lie, like a child with cookie crumbs still stuck on the corner of her lips insisting she was in the cookie jar. It simply does not matter to them. They just create a new truth in their heads and carrying on as if nothing matters. 'Tis just such responses, citing a single, artfully mischaracterized example to refute a carefully made argument that long ago led to the bit of male traditional wisdom that advises, never argue with a woman. Because women don't ordinarily engage in discourse to discover the truth as men do, not always, but men can be held to it if confronted, while women will dodge aka change the subject but merely to win. And all fair in war and love. Love here defined as any encounter between the sexes, and all fair because that how women fight. Philalethes number 8. When the cow rides the bull, priest, watch your skull. And there really no point in trying to convert them. It matters not a bit to convert such a creature any more than it does good to convince 3-year-olds that Ron Paul is the right candidate for president. Even the women that have been converted are simply incapable of rising above these things, and as soon as circumstances change, making her previous stance unsuitable for her, she rearranges the truth and carries on as if she has no clue to what you are talking about, nor can you hold her to what she said yesterday. So, what the point? There was a very well-known meritorious mediocrist in the MRM a few years back. She had everyone bamboozled that she was not like that. She spoke and blogged and moralized and agreed and agreed and agreed, and all the men were happier than pigs in shit that there was, finally, such a good example of woman. They didn't have to take women off the pedestal, not all of them, anyway. Phew. However, suddenly a lot of shit hit the fan. I don't know the details, just bits and pieces which are not important. She got herself onto the divorce conveyor belt. Shared parenting? Huh? What you talking about, Willis? Unreasonable child support? But I need it. Yeah. What a waste of time and effort for all the men who pedestalized her. She was no different than the rest, and her principles were subject to change simply upon the convenience of where she was in life. Even in relationships with men, women are completely malleable. The girl you dated at 21, who screwed you over at 23, is not even the same person when you speak to her again at 28. This is because women are empty vessels who seek men to fill the void. Each time a woman gets together with a new man, it is based upon hypergamy. He becomes her new hero, and thus she completely adapts her morals and character to be his view of the ideal woman. When she grabs hold of the next branch, man, all of her morals and character again change to adapt to be the new man ideal woman. When you look at it that way, how can one then ever assess a woman's true character? It does not exist. There is no point in arguing with them, and there is no point in having their input into men issues. Having a woman help with men issues is like having a 5-year-old help you put up wallpaper. No thanks. The influence of the Lacedaemonian women has been most mischievous. The evil showed itself in the Theban invasion, when, unlike the women of other cities, they were utterly useless and caused more confusion than the enemy. The politics of Aristotle, the Spartan women. It is best for men simply to take a position and staunchly never budge. Do not bother explaining yourself to women. It is futile. Either they find your logic to be sound and they will conform themselves around you, or there is no further hope in converting her to your way of thinking. A man has to come from the attitude of it my way or the highway. A woman or especially her friends may call this asshole behavior, simply because you are not willing to grovel like a servile worm for her approval, But deep down every woman loves this about a man. There is a difference between being an asshole and being confident and assertive. We have entirely different strategies and entirely different views of reality. It best to just chase them off so the men can get back to business. Interview with a woman firster, Phyllis Schlafly. Jack Cammer, what if I was the kind of man, like a lot of men who have confided to me, who is sick to death of the corporate world and in a heartbeat would stay home to take care of their kids because they love them so much and they know the business world is a crock. Phyllis Schlafly, /VT pitch. That their problem. As I look around the world about me, I just don't find there are many women who want the so-called non-traditional relationships. A radio interview, WCVTFM now WTMD, Towson University, Maryland. January 5, 1989. Off to the coffee clutch with you and the other clucking hens. For women, the temptation to misuse cunning, for example, to deceive corresponds to man temptation to misuse power. The fact that the woman guilt is always more strongly emphasized than the man is basically an indirect compliment to the woman, an admission of the degree to which she is the stronger sex in cunning. Woman Man. From Kierkegaard Journals. The consciousness of how one stands with other people occupies a relatively larger and larger part of the mind, the lower one goes on the scale of culture. Woman intuition, so fine in the sphere of personal relations, is seldom first rate in the way of mechanics. Hence Dr. Whately jest, woman is the unreasoning animal, and pokes the fire from the top. William James. Principles of Psychology. It is a mistake to argue with women. Arguments are all about words, and women in our culture don't match up words with actions and freely say things that don't make sense and then deny that they don't make sense. In short, they aren't honest when trying to solve problems using discussion, negotiation and compromise. The reason they aren't honest is because they are trying to be abusive and exploitative rather than having relationships based on mutual love and respect. Instead, deal with women in the realm of behavior. Point to a behavior you don't like and tell her to stop, or point out a missing behavior of hers and tell her to do it. Never discuss why you don't like it or why you want her to do something. Get used to saying the word no a lot, and never discuss things in terms of right and wrong it enough that you want it. Always have a consequence lined up if she refuses, and always come through with that consequence. Flaky girls get dumped, if you get my drift. This only works if you have her replacement waiting in the wings to take her place. Your needs, not people expectations, are what important. Understand that, in our culture, all girls are flaky and need to be dumped sooner or later, so don't hesitate to do so, or let them get away with anything. As this behavior among men becomes common, and it is, women flakiness will drop off dramatically.
And that is it for now. If this content was entertaining and interested you, please share, like, and subscribe to this channel. I am the Swan, leading men till dawn, and even beyond. Thanks for the audience.